You know, as most of you know, Rick and I created the Arizona Barbecue Festival. And so it's been sort of a dream of ours to maybe one day open a barbecue restaurant. And if you read Eater AZ, then you know that Chef James Porter of Petite Maison stole our idea. We had the plans for the place all laid out in a drawer in Rick's desk. Well, those plans went missing. And then we get the news on Chow Bella, Phoenix New Times food blog, that he's opening up a barbecue restaurant. It's named after his dad, Big Earl. So we're gonna go inside, we're gonna talk to James Porter, and we're gonna find out why he stole our idea. Hey, Porter! Porter! Hey, man, I got a few questions for you. The people of Eater AZ wanna know why you stole our barbecue restaurant idea.
Well, it's a great restaurant, right?
Well, of course, everybody loves barbecue, as we learned at the barbecue festival. I bet it's gonna be a big success.
We're hoping so. It's a great location. It's food for the people. It's all American.
It's food for the people. So this is going to be a family restaurant? Is that the deal?
Family restaurant. Kids welcome. Crayons, coloring books.
So what was this place? It was Union or something like that?
I think it was Union, then it was Nello's, then it was Jack's. A few little places, but it's in the heart of Old Town Scottsdale. It's a great location.
Right, right. So what do you got? Cien Agave is right across the street. You're on Scottsdale.
Cien Agave, Patty's, the shawarma joint. We got the pink...
The Sugar Bowl.
Sugar Bowl.
The pink place.
46 years it's been there.
No kidding. Yeah. That's a good omen. Good omen to have.
Good omen, great neighbors.
All right, so what's the deal? You're going with just kind of like a rustic tchotchke look? Like you're just going to busy up the place?
Kind of rustic and tchotchke. We got some old family heirlooms. We've got some new product that we're going to be pushing. We've got a whole retail line.
I hear the barbecue sauce. What's the story?
We teamed up with Desert Smoke Barbecue and kind of put some tinctures together, worked on our own formula and recipe of sauce, and we've got our product line here, so we're ready to go.
So who needs the fancy prosciutto slicer like Annie's is downtown? You've got the meat grinder.
Grandmammy and Grandpappy used to use that one.
Right on.
So we're pretty excited.
Cool. So this is going to be like retail area, I guess.
Retail
like
section all right, over here.
T-shirts,
we've got hats, T-shirts,
love it.
Stickers, magnets, high chairs, aprons, tongs, barbecue sauce, and rub.
Merchandise the shit out of this place. All right, I love it. So you're keeping these booths, little tables,
keeping the whole thing. Tables. We've got some pig parts all over the ground that are being stenciled. We got the Big Earl sign, little rustic Americana.
Are you guys serving panda?
It kind of looks, huh?
I mean, it looks a little bit like a panda, I gotta tell you. I hear that maybe panda ribs are the next big thing.
Well, who knows? Maybe you guys will open a panda restaurant. We've got some amazing beers on tap, a lot of the barbecue favorites, some local beers, 8th Street Ale, and of course, Bud Light out of mason jars.
You can't love it. Shiner Box, one of my favorites, and Bullet Bourbon's a big sponsor. You're wearing the t-shirt today.
We have a lot of whiskeys here at the whiskey bar area. A lot of whiskey-inspired cocktails, so it's going to be, you get a shot and a beer all day long.
Right, right.
PBRs all day long for $2, all sorts of great
things. Now, the place really is named after your dad, correct?
It is. Right. I figured that when I was born, I really didn't have a say-so in my name, so I figured I'd pass on that tradition and name a restaurant without him actually knowing about it.
What are we doing? Are we talking about menu items?
We're talking about menu items. Big Earl's has a lot of regional favorites, so we're not pinpointing ourselves with either one of the different North Carolina style or Memphis style. We're going to kind of pick the best of both worlds, and then a lot of regional favorites where I grew up. Central Florida, South Carolina, Mississippi, some places like that. So kind of tying all that together and bringing, the Americana food back to the people.
James Porter, I love the way you've taken our idea for a restaurant and just fed me a bunch of lies about your own life. I mean, it's really fantastic. I wish you the best of luck. I'll see you on this Saturday when you open.
Whenever opening day is, I love it.
Good luck, buddy. Cheers.
Thank you.